Hello
everyone. Today I'm going to show you about gastro and intestinal duplication cysts. Terminology: GI duplication cysts have three defining characteristics. Very developed coat of smooth muscle, epithelial lining representing some parts of GI tract. Attachment to GI tract, a rarely isolated cyst with no persistent attachment. Most common sign symptoms: pain, palpable mass, erectile bleeding, intussusception, or in valvulus cause small bowel obstruction. Most frequent presentation for ileus duplication may be incidental. Other signs and symptoms: laceration, perforation, hemorrhage, vascular compromise, and urinary retention have been reported for mass defect. Respiratory symptoms in thoracic and oral cavity lesion may be detected on prenatal sonography. 8. Congenital lesion, most often presenting less than 2 years of age, up to 85%, up to 30% present in adulthood. Epidemiology, prevalent of 1 per 4,500 fetal neonatal autopsy. Top differential diagnosis, mesenteric lymphatic malformation, ovarian cysts, meconium pseudocysts, orocosis, hydrometrocopus, cholecystitis, and aneurysm. Imaging: cystic around 8 to 90% versus tubular 10 to 20% lesion with well defined wall, can occur anywhere along GI tract, most frequently associated with ileum. More than 30% and esophagus 18 to 20%. Contiguous but not necessarily communicating with adjacent GI tract. Ultrasound is best modality to visualize key feature, though finding with highest specificity have lower sensitivity. Gut signature sign. Three lamina apparent of wall is less specific than five layer wall. Y sign. Hypoechoic muscularis propria divide at points of attachment between cyst and adjacent bowel. First, peristasis of cyst wall is pathognomonic if visualized. Ultrasound of the upper abdomen in a 15 months old with intermittent pains and vomiting show an allocolic intussusception extending to the transverse colon and terminating in a complex cystic mass with a three lamina wall. The mass was initially mistaken for fluid trapped around the intussusception. Frontal radiograph in the same patient after successful air enema reduction. So, a peristalsis ramus outlined by air in the mid-right abdomen concerning for a lead point. SSFSE T2MI in a week's old with a prenatally detected anomaly, so 3.5 cm cystic mass inferior to the liver and immediately lateral to the disc dilated common buttock. A duodenal duplication cyst compressing the common buttock was confirmed at surgery. Ultrasound since a month or so a well circumscribed around cyst of the right upper quadrant with a pre-laminar gut signature wall confirmed to be an enteric duplication cyst at surgery. Five layer can be seen in portion of the wall. Contrast intensity show a large bilobed cystic lesion in the upper abdomen with well-defined wall. The cystic lesion was resected and found to be a gastric duplication. Treatment: complete surgical resection is ideal. Partial excision with the removal of lining or mask. Subpolarization may be required in difficult region. Thank you.